Now we have a segment called the crystal ball. Okay?
Oh man, my ball is glitchy,
so,
yo.
Crystal here, she has a magic ball.
Struggling.
Crystal ball, and she predicts the outcome of the next round.
I'm struggling.
So, what are we doing is two parts. First, we're going to go see what happened last week and if the ball was right or wrong. And then we're going to see what she predicts for next week. Okay? Now, I have to say, last week, the ball was way off, Crystal. I don't know, maybe because the playoffs, but it was way off.
All
right,
y'all.
Okay, first was the game, Ra'anana, Bnei Yehuda. Right? You had two games.
Yeah.
You had Thursday. So we'll go quickly on Ra'anana.
I'm always rooting for y'all, by the way, but...
So let's see. No. So Ra'anana, Bnei Yehuda, she said Ra'anana will win 86-66 by 20 points, he gave you. You beat them by 12 points, 70-58.
She didn't say to me, so...
No, but you told me you used the podcast, you told me. You played the podcast to your players before playing Herzliya?
Before Herzliya, because she said it's easy 20.
That's because I wanted it to be an easy 20.
This is the problem.
The stress. All right, let's get it.
Okay,
what's going on?
Let's move on. Rishon Ramat HaSharon, you got it right also. Then you start getting mistakes. Rishon Ra'anana. She bet against you. She did a mistake. She said Rishon will beat Ra'anana 69-59.
Oh, I must have didn't understand. I must have didn't understand the question.
She's a good player. Who
it's not her. It's the ball.
Game.
It's the ball. It's not her. So Ra'anana beat Rishon 82-73 last night.
Nice. Shout out to Bria. How many she have? How did Bria do?
She didn't play a lot. She had 20-22. I don't know.
It's not
I'm
bad.
Not counting.
Okay, me either then.
Okay.
Nice.
I'm not counting 34 points.
I don't count. You got it.
Okay. Yeah, of course.
You don't count.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Where we at?
Only we believe.
Okay.
I believe.
The ball was way off also in Bnei Yehuda's game. You gave Bnei Yehuda the first victory. You
that
said
is not what I said.
63-59, and they lost 90-71. Will Bnei Yehuda win this season?
We were just trying to get them to win. That was Jamie and Tiff on their side. I didn't say that.
Will they have a win? You have two more games.
Don't want to talk about
next question. Next question. Ramle Herzliya. Ramle Herzliya. You said Herzliya will beat Ramle
75-73. This is a tricky question.
And they lost by 4 points. Now, do you want to speak about that?
What was the score about the loss?
No,
71-67.
But at the halftime,
that was so
they were up by 17.
Tell me what happened, because you wrote me, I don't want to speak, we'll speak in the podcast. What happened?
Why'd you tell him that much? All right, see, that sensitive side is coming out.
No, I didn't tell him.
You just told the whole podcast.
Yeah, so tell me what happened.
All right, yo.
This is like therapy.
So we were up 17. So I'm like, we were up 17.
In halftime.
Yeah, we was up at 17. To be honest, I don't remember our halftime speech. Could be the problem. But I didn't remember it just because I felt like we were doing everything right. And I was speaking about talking on defense, and we talked on defense. The offense was flowing, and everything that was working for us the first half, we stopped doing the second half. And it's like sometimes when things are going so right, you're like, oh, okay, what changes I got to make? I know somebody had screamed out in the huddle. We were in the huddle, and we were all making threes, and somebody screamed out in the huddle. They said that the shots that were falling this half is not going to fall the next half. You got to do something else. And it's like, I'm like, maybe we should do what we've been doing. So we stopped doing what we were doing, which is playing defense and offense to sum up the game.
How does it happen, Coach? What
does
do you
that make sense,
say?
Edney, to you?
It makes sense. But when you are talking, coaches and players see the game differently, 180 degrees. And when she's saying, yes, in the end, statistics is not going, you are not making 40% and today you will make 90. Doesn't work. You made 90, in the end you will make 40.
All right. So what do you do as a coach?
This is a problem. It's a problem. You have to deal with it, but I'm not saying, first of all, with all again, Ramle is a very good team. Very good team with good Americans and good Israelis. And this and more experienced players. And when you are playing in Herzliya with young players, there's a price for everything. You pay.
So it's experience. More experience wouldn't lose.
We've been talking about that from the very podcast when we was over there.
Yeah.
Why everyone is talking about Ramat Chen? Because they have experienced Israelis.
And experienced Americans.
Nachon, Adut is very experienced.
Not very experienced. She played one season in Israel, second 2 months in Turkey.
Yeah.
Russia. Came back to Israel.
Came back.
Smart lady.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. She likes it here.
Yeah, so, I mean, like you said, coaches and players think different because, you know, I'm sorry, just take this from me. What I'm saying is, if you're shooting 90 in first half, a player believes you can shoot 90 second half. That's what you believe. But statistically and, you know, hypotheticals and everything else, you guys want to go with statistics. And sometimes amazing is when amazing happens. Just like us being up 17 and a half. That's amazing. So when you have an amazing show going on, keep the show rolling. Do not try to dim down the mediocrity. You don't want to start that. You want to keep it amazing.
But I will give you an example, okay? An example. I'm shouting a lot of time on Bria when she takes three pointers, even though she's wide open. And I'm telling her, now it's the fourth quarter. You are more tired. The legs are tired. And there are times that even though it looks easy, it's not that easy. And you have to go and penetrate. And she's looking at me most of the time and she says, what do you want? I was free. And I'm saying, yes, you were free, but it's still not a great shot. Okay. There are times that you have to understand what's the situation on the court. When you penetrate, so even if you are not making 3 points, you make 2 points, or you're going to the line and then you have another 15 seconds to rest. It's worthwhile than a three-pointer. This is the way coach...
Yeah, players don't have a bad shot. For the players...
They feel it, and I understand it.
I'm rocking with you on that, though.
But
on
there
what?
Are times...
With me? What are you saying?
There are times that you have to understand. Yes, the three-pointers that I took in the third period, I couldn't miss.
Mm-hmm.
But in the end... I will not make a 9 out of 10. I will make, in bad days, I will make 2 out of 10. In normal days, I will make 4 out of 10.
Mm-hmm.
And in great days, I will make 6 out of 10. The question is, when will the 4 misses will be? In the first half or in the end of the game, for example.
Okay.
So in other words, I feel like we played our best basketball the first half. And we threw out that Thriller album. You know, we threw out that Michael Jackson Thriller album our first half, and we just couldn't get back to that. I think we were trying to, but we just couldn't get back to what was working, pretty much.
And they were playing better, though.
They were playing better. They made adjustments at halftime, so.
You know, also, the game I saw, Ramat Chen, Petah Tikva.
Oh, man.
Second half, Ramat Chen came very aggressive. They were down 7 at halftime, and they came, boom. And they were leading by the third quarter.
Katya was good.
Katya was amazing. She had like 22 points. And she was all over. She coached them very good, I have to say. When they came the second half, you could feel after 10 seconds, it's a completely different team.
I heard Petah Tikva was cheated out again. I heard it was the refs.
They were?
Was it blatant? I heard it was blatant, like just bad calling.
The coach? No, they were bad.
It was just evenly.
Bad.
It was just bad, bad.
Yeah, they were evenly. Yeah. No, they're evenly. They had a tech for the coach of Petah Tikva. He got a tech. Alex
really?
Harden was amazing. Harden, had
really?
She had a winner shot.
Nice.
Yeah.
Very
shout
nice.
Out to Alex.
Was it a mid-range? It probably was a pull-up, Jay.
It was a pull-up.
Yeah, that's her shot.
Okay, so let's go. Let's finish with you. Ramat Chen, you said, will lose to Petah Tikva, and they beat them. And Ashdod Chulon, everybody said Chulon will lose. To Ashdod, which what happened?
One out of six.
Okay,
so
you want
to
go?
I think it was two. Look, I'm ready to redeem myself. Let's go. You can't. Let's go.
Whose laugh is
play
that?
Play it again. Play it one more time.
Whose laugh is that?
You know who that laugh is?
Well, that's Kawhi. Let me sing it. Kawhi Leonard. Okay, I have another one. Let's see if you know who is this one. Who is this laugh?
That's too quick. Who is that? Carl Towns?
Russell Westbrook.
Oh, I hear it. Okay.
Okay. Take out the ball.
Do you guys know the OKC Thunder had Kevin Durant, James Harden, and Russell Westbrook?
And Serge Ibaka, even.
Sheesh.
No, we're not talking about that. I was a
stick with the team. Don't worry about the money.
No, I'm not saying
sound
that.
Soundbite.
But when the differences are not big, stay.
I agree.
I agree, but also, you know, the owner is a billionaire. You know, he should put the money. You know,
talking, yeah, we're talking marbles.
Earthly, not
yeah,
w,
not
no
yeah.
Okay, take out the ball. Tululu, tululu, tululu. Look at her, Ednie. Look at her focus. Tululu. First game.
Ooh, I'm ready. Let's go.
Ramle Ramatchen. What does the ball say? Ramle Ramatchen. What will be the score?
Well, who do I want to win?
You don't ask. You look at the ball and just give.
Yeah, I know. I'm gonna go with Ramatchen 4 points.
Give us a score. We need a score.
And Ramle, they're my girls over there, but I'm gonna give it to Ramatchen.
Jamie, Tiffany, if you're listening, she's going with Ramatchen.
Yeah.
Okay, what's the score?
You know I owe them dinner. They keep holding it down. I told them I'm gonna make them a home cooked meal.
Are you playing them again this season?
Yeah, in the cup, in the championship.
So we'll wait with that. Wait with that dinner.
Okay, so I don't have to pay.
I'm sorry,
I don't have
Jamie,
to, yeah.
Tiffany. Wait with that dinner.
We'll wait on the dinner.
Okay, give me a score.
We got
Ramle Ramatchen.
64-66.
Ooh, close game.
Oh, they're going to win by 4. 64-68. Sorry.
To Ramatchen.
Yeah. Okay.
Coach, what do you have to say about that game?
Nothing.
His crystal ball is not the Edney
working.
Ball.
Not working.
All right, let's go. Let's get through this though. I got all the numbers. Let's
okay,
go.
Okay.
I'm rolling.
Second game. You ready? Tululu, tululu, tululu. Petach Tikva and Chulon. Who's gonna beat that game? Do you have a score? Coach, coach, help her out. Coach, what do you say?
71-66 Petach Tikva.
You think Petach Tikva will come back? Both teams lost this round.
Yeah. I need Shea to have that takeover. That takeover.
It's a critical game.
It is critical for her. I need my daughter to go in. I need Shea Kelly to go in.
Hulon will win.
Hulon will win.
Yeah.
You're going with Hulon.
Eddie said Hulon will win.
My pen doesn't write now.
If Shea get the rolling, I need Shea to have 30-17 again.
Shea Kelly.
I need Shea to 30.
Shea Kelly. She gets the rebound.
She involves everybody. She's being a playmaker right now. She gotta go for broke. That's the saying we use. She gotta go for broke. If not, my girls Mo Reed over there, Alexis Peterson, they're
playing. I'm gonna write here. My pen stopped
working. They're playing phenomenal right now.
Okay, so what are we saying? 71.
71 to Petach Tikva. 66.
To Petach Tikva. You said Chulon.
She said Petach Tikva.
71-66 to Petach Tikva. Okay. You have anything to say, Coach?
Never.
He said it's critical.
And he doesn't have a ball.
And he said,
and he said never. Hulon, it's very important. It's if Hulon wins this game, they're in the final four.
Okay.
Ooh, I need my dog to get
to
the final four.
What about Nofar? Nofi. We want Nofi in the final four.
Come on, I want my crystal ball to be wrong on this.
With all the crystal ball?
Yeah.
Crystal Bradford, unfortunately, won't be in the final four.
I know these numbers is bad. We can't even talk about this right now.
The crystal ball is
plan
not
for
biased.
Next season.
It's not biased, you know. It's very professional podcast, guys. Okay. I keep telling it.
Okay. Ednie, plan for next season.
The ball doesn't know. Ednie, we'll see you next season. Next game.
We'll see you next season.
Next game, we'll play the soundbite.
Let's
see
go.
You. Okay.
Maybe she'll play for me. What do you know?
Next time
we are meeting next season.
Okay, you know what? Awesome. I'm going to give you now an opportunity
Ednie's
for a comeback.
Guy.
I'm
going to
give you an opportunity for a comeback. What does the ball say about Ramat HaSharon playing Ra'anana?
Ra'anana's going to win by 12.
Oh, the ball likes Ra'anana. Okay, give me a score.
60-72.
72-62 Ra'anana. Coach, it's your team. What do you have to say about this?
I'm not talking about my team.
He's so politically correct.
I thought
so much more of you.
I can say that Ramat HaSharon is the disappointment of the season.
Ramat HaSharon?
Honestly, yeah. So yeah. many trades and... Yeah,
trades and money.
Yeah,
if you say by money, they are on the second or third place in the league. They... Disappointment, big one. The Israelis and the Americans, they made trades and this and that. And
so many trades.
I liked it. I took... I took Tiana.
Yeah, because you took the player.
Right. Yeah. I liked it.
That was a good grab, Etney. That was a boss move right there.
Yeah.
Boss move.
Yeah, you have many boss moves. So 72-60 to Ranana.
Yeah.
No comment from coach?
No.
You know.
Not talking about my players.
Okay, no. So next game, you need to speak. Let's see.
Let me stay focused. I'm ready.
Okay. Bnei Yehuda Rishon.
Bnei Yehuda and Rishon.
What does
Rishon
the boss say?
Rishon going to get him about. Rishon going to get him.
Give us a score.
60-75
to Rishon. Yep. Yes, coach. Rishon have very young Israeli players, are very promising.
But they are rocking and rolling. You got heart or you got experience. So if you don't have experience, you gotta have heart.
Yeah.
Heart mistakes. And their I need
young
heart
players
mistakes.
Are very good. They have experience from Adi Lux and three young ones. Very good. Daniel, Gili, and Gaia, I think.
So what was the question? Listen. The thing, first of all, I don't want Bnei Yehuda. This is personal. I don't want Bnei Yehuda to win any game.
You don't want them to win?
No.
How come?
No.
He can't elaborate. Don't for it. You know what?
I thought that they don't have to stay in the league.
Last season. Mm-hmm. You know, they said from technical reasons, Crystal.
I told you in next season they can't. But yeah. I said last season that they shouldn't be in the league. I'm behind it. They shouldn't be. It's not good for the women basketball in Israel.
Why not? It's not good.
And this is the results are this. Listen, not to win even one game in a season shows that the club is not is nothing.
Okay.
Okay. I mean, but I agree. I just feel like, what's going on? I agree. But I mean, I don't want anybody to go down because...
I want players, American players, for example, when they're coming over here, that they will feel good. Good apartments, good places. Treat them right. And like... I said to a manager there, think that your daughter is going to work abroad. When you look at an apartment that she will live, think if your daughter, what you would have said if your daughter was living in this apartment.
Mm. And they have bad apartments?
Right, yeah.
And it starts here.
Okay.
I don't want to get into, but it starts here. It's a pity, and I hope they will not win. I hope they will. I know they will go to the second division, and that's it.
Okay, sad story. Yeah. Sad story.
Sad, very sad.
I agree.
Ta-na-na-na-na. Tat-tat. Okay. Okay, let's change the atmosphere. We have one more game. Coach...
Yeah, I must say, you got a better sound bite for
Which
us.
One?
Okay, let's see. Do you know this team? Herzliya and Ashdod. Ooh, what does the ball say about Herzliya and Ashdod? You check the ball, coach, you have a chance
We're
to gonna say something.
We're going to get them by 4. 68-72.
Wow, I like the confidence. I like the confidence.
68-72.
You love the 72, Crystal. You know, every time you give the 72.
Because it's like it's 70 and then something else happens. Next thing you know, it's 72. Somebody makes two free throws, ice the game. I got D.A. tired. I got D.A. tired. And, you know, hopefully she eats a lot of cookies and have a lot of drinks for her birthday. Celebrate, D.A. Live it up to the fullest.
Yeah.
Go so hard right now. Just don't remember. Let's go. Go hard. You can't remember.
Very important game for Herzliya. If they're losing.
That's it. You got to win. You got to win until the end.
Win. Yeah.
We should have beat. They don't matter. Oh, man, I'm about to go party with DA now. Man. Oh, man, pass me one of those.
Coach, what do you have to say about this game? Herzliya must win 70-68. Do you see this score coming in the next game?
Might be. Might be. But I don't know how important it is for Ashdod, because I think that even if they win, they cannot be in the second place. So it's not very important.
Oh, I'm going to tell my friends that. Yeah, I have some friends,
Chelsea,
over in Ashdod.
Yeah, text Chelsea right now.
She knows. She knows. Chelsea is always aware of stuff. Chelsea is really aware. Yeah. So I'm going to tell her. As a matter of fact, when we going up for a jump, before we even jump, I'm going to be like, y'all know this don't mean nothing.
Yeah, exactly.
This means everything to us.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Let's see.
So I hope you win, because we got to keep the league interesting. We got to keep it interesting.